Hey guys, we are here at Gen Con 2016 with a brand new release from Fantasy Flight Games, Ruin Wars, the miniatures game. It's an old style miniatures game with some new mechanics. We're going to take a look at it with Tony here. He's going to demo, and Chris from Merc Runner. And what's the podcast?
Dog and Thimble Podcast.
Dog and Thimble Podcast. So join us. Tony, it's all yours.
All right. So this is the new minis game. It has functionality like Armada in the different objectives that you can do and the way you can set up your lists and things, and then movement templates that are slightly reminiscent of X-Wing. So it's kind of a weird combination of all of that. Movement templates over there. So the way it works, the basics of it, you have these here, or the units. You can create your teams, you'll have your different points, different upgrade costs, a lot of team building just like X-Wing, Armada, stuff like that. Units will come in trays like this of groups of four, or on the heroes one, the horses two, things like that. You'll buy them by the tray as far as for point cost, and then they'll hook them together into squads. Now the whole squad will move and activate together, which is really kind of interesting, and they'll move as a group. The way you set up the trays will also matter for gameplay. Let's say you had like six of these trays of regular guys. If you do them three wide by two deep, it's different, you get different effects than if you do them two wide by three deep. Generally, the wider they are, the more top-end damage you can do, because it'll multiply their damage.
Right.
But the deeper they are, the more rerolls you get, so the more consistent the damage. And then as units get taken off and killed, the trays will get removed, and then that'll change your shape, which will change how effective that unit is.
Okay.
So it's kind of a really cool mechanic that I haven't really seen before. You do also have like hero units that are kind of in a base on their own. What's really cool about this too is these heroes can actually come out of the base, and then there are upgrades that will allow you to like add a hero, say, to one of these groups to up that entire group in some way. Now, you won't get the full effect of the hero by himself, but it'll buff up a group in a really big way. So sometimes, depending on how your list is built, that can be
cool.
A really big deal. The way the movement templates work, so once we do actions and stuff, I'll kind of show how all that works. They kind of just hook into the sides here, and then you just move them up and hook them up there. So you've got a lot of different speeds you can do as far as straights. You can curve them, things like that. The base way to kind of get everyone going is once you start moving these trays up into another tray, when they hit, they'll engage with each other, and then you kind of straighten them up on each other, and now those two units are basically stuck together until something happens.
Nice.
There are ways to disengage, but it's bad for you, so you don't want to do it too much if you don't have to. So that's kind of the trick, is being able to grab people with the right units that are good against whatever units are
coming.
Nice.
So you can lock them up, basically.
Yep.
Keep them engaged. Cool.
Yep. So there's a lot of different things you can do. Some of them will have ranged attack. You got your archers over here. Your basic footmen are just kind of your generic melee type. The knights have like special abilities where they can charge in, so they can generally move faster, and they'll get bonuses when they, and if they're the ones to initiate against a unit versus the other unit initiating against them.
Right.
The heroes are just awesome and have a ton of cool skills. So they're kind of just good on their own. They just kind of wander the battlefield and just wreak havoc. So it's pretty awesome. So the way that you start out, every set of units will have one of these double command dials. And so this is kind of how you choose stuff. So you'll choose all of this in secret for each of your sets of units ahead of time. And so what you do, you'll have all these different actions. Now every unit will have different sets of actions on their dial. And then the second dial is a modifier that will somehow affect the first action, depending on how you do it.
Is this like X-Wing where like based on the model, it'll have different things they got around there?
Yep, okay, yep, cool. Definitely. Lots of different ones depending, because like the horses have faster movements, but then they don't turn as well, type of things. So the way it works is you'll have like your movement things, 1, 2, 3, 4 speed move. Those are all straight movements, normal movement, unless you add the modifier to bank or hard turn if you happen to have it, which I don't think these ones have. But normally the bank will have like a negative speed. So if you dial up a 3 straight with a bank, it'll actually be a 2 bank, which is how you do that. And so the modifier has to match in color. The only modifier color that doesn't have to match is the white can match to anything. So no matter what action you put up here, the white, if there's a white modifier, it can just happen.
And so in this case, the green and the yellow are always going to be either the white or the blank?
Yep.
Okay.
If you happen to dial up something that doesn't match, it just doesn't, the modifier doesn't take effect.
Okay.
And so the way that that works is you can say, do a 3 straight, and you want to do a 3 straight, or if you want to charge, if you run into someone, it lets you take an attack against them right away. Or if you don't think you're going to hit somebody, you're not trying to charge into somebody, you could dial up the plus one defense there, and then you'll get plus one defense that whole round, but you wouldn't get the attack if you happen to charge into somebody. That's the way that works. The basic movement of it is when you do these moves, if you do a move without the charge modifier and hit another group, that's actually bad for you, and you take a morale token. I'll explain what those do later.
Okay.
If you're going to hit somebody, you want to do it charge, and then you'll get your attack, and that's good for you. If you happen to activate first and run into them, and then they had a charge or a move, it just doesn't happen because you're already engaged. So how you activate or what order you activate in is massive. And the way that works is you'll see each of these has a white number by it. That's initiative order. And the cool thing about that is whatever you set for your action, so it'll be like one person will have an initiative token and that switches between rounds. And then they'll be like, okay, who has a one to activate? If you have a one, you activate it. If not, you go on to two, three, and then if you have multiple overlapping of a number, that's where the initiative token, you go back and forth. Now, the thing that's cool about that is some units, like this one per se, has an attack with three, but it has an attack with seven. Now, it has a modifier for the red that adds an extra hit result on the attack with red. So you can attack quick at initiative three, which is awesome, quick attack, but it won't hit as hard as if you do the later attack with the extra modifier.
Nice. Charge it up.
So there's a lot of customization that way with the dials, which is really, really cool. Other things you can do, the green one is, or that one there is rally. That's when we get into like status effects, any type of status effect, rally will take them all away. Or if you don't happen to have a status effect at that time when you activate it, you get a little token that you can spend later to get rid of one status. So that's kind of nice. You also have different formations setups, and then movement is always going to be forward and like curved and stuff, except for if you have shift, which he has here. So if you don't mind, thank you. Shift, this one here, will let you move in any direction speed one. So you can sidestep or back up. That's the only way you can do it is by using shift. Now, the only when you're engaged with each other, you can't move through each other. You can't really move at all. The only way you can move is by shifting. But if you if you're engaged and you shift away, you have to take a morale token as kind of fleeing the battle. So it's a way to get disengaged, which sometimes is worth it, sometimes is not.
Nice.
So that's the general actions. Then this one here is just a generic skill action. Different units will have skills on their unit cards. So like this guy here. So the Rune Golem has a skill. Each enemy unit engaged with you receives a stun token. So you can do that skill, and then they'll take that stun token, which is cool. And then you could also do a plus one defense with it and up your defense. One thing that's kind of cool, too, is the runes that you throw out. So we've got these tokens here. And there's different units that will use different magic runes. So every round, at the beginning of the round, you'll drop these out, and whatever they come up as will determine the runes. Now, the big one is you've got one for your basic footman to regenerate. His undead footman can come back if he leaves, like if you kill, say, two of them and leave empty spaces in a tray, the tray doesn't go away yet.
Yeah.
He might be able to get guys back at the end of the round. Once the tray is out, can't refill it. But that requires green runes to be up. Your Rune Golem has a bunch of different skills based on what runes are up. I think the red ones, if I remember, will affect his attack, and the blue ones will affect his speed, if I remember correctly. So we'll have to look at that. You can pre-measure to some extent with everything except movement templates. You can't pre-measure movements when you're setting up stuff, but you can pre-measure range. We're using that range ruler you've got there to check. As of right now with this demo stuff, with the base stuff, the range on the range ruler actually doesn't matter. All that matters is whether you're in range or not to shoot at stuff.
Okay.
For now, there are different upgrades that will matter for the range.
So, does it specify what the range is within this for different attacks, or is it just like?
For right now, with what you've got, any ranged attack can do that.
Okay.
Yep, and any melee attack just has to be touching.
Not quite in range.
And then with these rune tokens, one thing to note too, down on the bottom, it'll show you what's on the other side. So that way you kind of know how likely it is to come up. The red are doubles, but there's only two total sides. So it can be 0, 4, 2. It's very, up or down. the blue are, there's a bunch of blue sides, and one of them has it on both sides.
So you're gonna get that.
So you'll always get at least one blue, sometimes up to three.
Right.
And then the green are very rare, but once they come up, there's three of them. It can go up to three, but there's only one side on each one.
Okay.
So that's a good thing to remember while you're playing out. So the way attacks work, you'll always have attacks down at the bottom of your cards there for ranged or melee, or if the thing is just ranged or melee, it'll show that. And that'll show you what dice you roll for those specific attacks. Obviously, you have to be engaged with each other to do a melee attack. Range just has to, you can basically have to go from anywhere on one of the bases to anywhere on the other base with this, which right now is going to be very easy to do.
Okay.
And so the dice here, pardon my reach, don't want to bump anything. Oh, okay. Yep. So the dice you'll use for attacks, you've got different ones here. The red ones have a bunch of different, you know, the attack symbol is damage. This is for morale, which we'll get into in a minute. And then you also have surges, which can be used for different surge abilities, which will be familiar if you played any, a lot of our other games, Descent, Imperial Assault, things like that. The blues are a little bit more generic. They have a lot more surges, less damage. Accuracy, which won't matter here, but when you have a hero embedded in one of the groups, you have to take from the back ranks first when you're killing things. So if the hero's way up front, it's hard to get that upgrade out. Accuracy will let you do that. So some units can be very accurate with their fire, take him out.
Nice.
And then these hero die are usually only used by hero units, and they're very, a lot of damage, a lot of powerful stuff, including kills that'll do damage even through armor.
Wow.
Just does, completely ignores armor.
Goodness.
Yeah. A lot to it, it's a decent, but once you get playing, it's honestly not that bad. The biggest thing is remembering what all these actions do, and as soon as you start playing, that comes second nature.
I mean, for a traditional miniatures game, it is not thick at all.
No,
right?
Not bad compared
to a 300-page rulebook.
Yeah, yeah. And we try to keep everything as simple as possible. We want to give you a deep experience, but we also don't want you drowning. So there's that. One last thing I'll touch on before we actually just get into the meat of it is the morale deck. So those morale tokens I was talking about, sometimes you'll get them for disengaging or some effects. And what that does is when there's a bunch of morale tokens on you, if you attack someone and you get one of these morale symbols that I could find right there, the swirly, you get to activate morale on someone. So you take any of those morale symbols you rolled, plus any tokens that they have on that unit, and you can draw that many of the cards off the morale deck. So let's say you had three morale against that unit. You draw the top three cards, and now you can spend, you can buy one of these cards using up to that many tokens. So if you only have one token on it, you could draw one card and hope you could get it. Maybe you wouldn't. And they can be really bad. Some of them can go up to three, where you have to have three tokens just to buy it in and use it against them.
This is a bad thing,
it's
right?
Bad.
This is a demoralized
you don't want
army,
this.
Right?
Yep. Okay. It's pretty bad. Stuff like making you run away, move away, different things that'll stun you and make you lose actions, things like that. Excellent. A lot of the rest of it is just going to kind of come by playing it out. So if you want to take a round or two here, we'll do that.
Let's do it. Let's do a quick round.
All right. So just to kind of get everything rolling for you, I'm going to kind of put some units there. All right. So you match up the units with this. So this one's got the horses. So that's where you'll see these guys don't actually have a hard turn at all, but they've got some pretty fast movement up to a four, and their charge doesn't lower down the speed at all, only if it's going a curve charge.
Okay.
So the big thing to remember is, depending on the way your initiative works and who activates first, you want to run into people when you have a charge up. You do not want to run into them when you have a normal move up. So.
All right, here's our dials.
Yep, so those are all the dials.
And we'll distribute these to the appropriate Jakarian Lancers.
Yep. So let's see. So you got your
reanimate
cavalry there.
Get some spearmen.
Spearmen. Your rune golem will be this guy here. And this is where those runes will matter. So you see this here? It doesn't have a speed for the move. It will move as fast as you have red runes showing.
Okay.
So it could move. That could be up to a four move at initiative four. But if the runes don't shake out for you at the beginning of that round, that move isn't going to be very good for you.
And okay, so do you see the runes before you make your decisions?
You do, in fact. Yep.
Okay.
Yeah, the first thing you do when a round starts is you pass the initiative token, which will be actually just that round counter there.
This thing here?
Yep. You pass that to the next person, because it switches between rounds. You drop out these runes, then you make your decisions, and then you activate, and that's the way it works.
All right, so Chris, so, you want me to roll these runes?
Yeah, go for it.
Let's make it happen.
All right, drop those out. Excellent. All right, so we ended up with one blue, oops, two red, and two green total. Now, depending on what type of skills you have that those matter for, your big ones are over here. Basically, the blue ones are for brutal, which I'll explain that once we actually get into some combat, but it's good for you. The more blues out there, the more you're upgrading his damage.
Okay.
That rune golem does a lot of damage based on the blue runes.
So let's you know, we're just going to make this happen. Oh, how interesting. So does this mean I can go either direction?
Yep. Okay. That's a good point, actually. The direction
so this is any direction.
The turns doesn't
I can go
matter.
Left or right.
When you activate, it's just a bank. You choose which side you want to go to.
Okay, so like if I chose this one, I could be going that way.
Yep, so if you chose this is a three straight, but then if you do this one, it would be a two charge.
Okay.
If you did this one, it would be a
Dude,
hard
let's roll.
Turn
what do you think?
One.
Okay.
And either way, you could go either direction. When you activate, you decide. So that's how that works.
Okay.
I mean, you have to pay attention to the initiative, too.
Yeah. Yep, and the initiative is where it really comes into play, because there's a lot of good stuff that units can do, but it might be on a really late initiative.
My brain is
and then you're like,
right
the other
way.
Guy activates all of his stuff, and none of it's where you expected it to be, and you're like, I really shouldn't have waited for that really powerful attack. Now I'm in trouble.
Okay.
So.
And is there any sort of, like, range of, like, motion and... Yeah,
an
arc.
Yeah. As far as for arc, it's basically these little marks on the side here.
Okay.
And so that's another thing. The wider you're facing, the wider your arc, which is really handy as well.
And what about maybe sort of like am I blocking line of sight or anything like that?
There are some things that'll do that. For the demo, I'm going to kind of stay away from that just because there's a couple of rules there that,
that's
we're just going to kind of keep it a little simple. In the full game, some units will obstruct attack, like ranged attacks, and some terrain will as well. But that's, we'll leave that for later.
Fair enough. What's
the numbers on the front of the dials?
The numbers
on the front of the dial.
I have no idea what this does.
Well, that's armor and wounds?
Yep, so your wounds and your armor. Actually, that's a good point that I didn't get into either. So each unit will have a separate set of wounds and armor. If you do, so the armor value, which we will show right here, is a good one. So on his hero here, she has a 3 armor value and a 4 wounds. If you do 5 damage, she takes 1 wound. Every time you fill that armor value, it's 1 wound. So you'd have to do 6 damage to her to do a second wound, if that makes sense. Any extra is just falling off.
Ah. Okay.
So if armor...
So 3 or less,
it's going to be some heartbreaking rolls.
Anything
right
less
there.
Than 3 is going to be 0 damage to her. 3 would give her 1 damage, and then up 6 would give her the second one.
Okay.
So if she's... And that's... a lot of times the human side, kind of, has a lot more armor.
Yeah.
And tends to be a lot better with their activations. Whereas his side is more about status effects and regenning guys, which can be a real pain if you let him do it.
Wicked. All right, I'm ready. I have a lot of symbols. I don't know what they mean. We're just going to see what happens.
There you go. That's the best way to learn. So here's how it'll start. So first we'll go, does anyone have any initiative 1 to activate? Usually not. I don't know. I've only seen, I think, 1 of them, that is. Anyone have an initiative 2 to activate? 3? No? 4?
Yes.
He's got a 4. You've got a 4
as
well?
We both got a 4. Okay.
All right. So because he has initiative this round, your one of your 4s activates. If you have multiple, it's just 1 for now.
Only 1.
One at a time. Okay.
One at a time, back and forth. Yep.
Okay, gotcha.
All right, do I reveal this?
You reveal that.
I got 3 forward, and then I chose that just to see what it does. I don't remember what it was.
No, it's... That would be an accuracy result, but because it doesn't match and you're not doing an attack anyway, it's not going to matter.
Perfect.
But that's okay.
Okay, so show me how this fits in there.
So this is the way this works for movement. So you'll take this and, let's see, if I remember correctly, okay. So you take this and you just kind of square it up.
Okay.
And then you pop that up and it just locks in, let's see if I remember correctly. Oh yeah, right there. So it just locks in just like that.
Okay.
So the little tabs, it basically has room so the little tabs can sit and you're still straight on.
Absolutely. So. Okay.
And these are really nice.
Yeah, they are.
The last time I played with it, it was like paper cutouts. That was really...
Totes jelly.
Yeah.
All right, that's it. That's my 4. That's all
so
I got.
So that's that.
So I'm going to get this Carrion Lancer going.
All right.
So I've got a 2 move. So
you've got a 2.
This one right here.
Yep.
I'll just get this out of the way so I get it.
There you go.
I feel like I have to be like Indiana Jones at the beginning of Raiders. trying to make sure I don't do anything to this.
Like, yeah. Yeah, they put that into us, the fear of God if we damage the minis.
Pre-production model,
there
don't
you go.
Break.
Yep.
It's great if you bought it.
They do look really nice, though. I like these
minis.
All right, so that's the movement.
Okay.
Now, because he put a charge modifier on that, but didn't run into anybody, you will take one of the morale tokens. So if you don't mind one of those little swirly orange tokens there, there you go. And at the moment, that has no effect, but it might later on.
So that's something that you can spend to...
to do bad stuff to you later on.
You got super pumped and nobody was home.
Yeah.
Like, let's go, let's do it.
Let's go, nobody's there.
Where is it?
All right. So now, is there any other fours?
No fours.
Any fives?
Yes.
All right, you have initiative.
I have one five. All right, so, and then do I need to unlink these to move them or should
they? Nope, they all move as one big unit.
Can I, like, pick them up?
Yeah, you can generally, should be able to pick it up.
Yeah. I'm so scared.
Yeah. Does have you ever change the formation, or is it as soon as you set it, that's it for the whole battle?
You choose that before the battle starts, and then however you have it set, that's how it is.
That's how it is.
Yep.
Okay.
Things will, kill units and change the formation, but that's not really up to you. That's more up to the person doing the killing.
Right.
Seems reasonable, right? This is safe.
Yeah, it's usually a little easier when there's not a. Unit, or when there's not models that you have to be insanely kid glove with, so.
Yeah, worth noting, these are...
so it touches in,
All right.
All right, so just like that.
And then, I did have a bank, which I didn't do.
Oh, for sure,
Let's ignore that for now, because I don't want to take that back.
Sounds like a plan. Yep.
I made it out of there without breaking anything, I feel good already.
There you go.
Okay.
All right, so do you have a five?
I have two fives.
So active.
So
here's the one. So now both of yours activate since he doesn't have another.
All right. So I've got a three move and it's a charge.
Okay.
So let's see.
So grab out that.
Let me ask you before I do
this.
Can you attack into a combat like my head? I'll just show it because you know I have.
Oh, sure.
I have shooting this one.
Yep.
And I have charging this one. Can I shoot after I'm like if I. I don't know if I'm even going to
hit. Oh, like you mean it shoot at something that's engaged with someone else? You can. Now, in the main rules, if you're shooting at something engaged to someone else, you do have to put a morale token on your unit that's engaged with them.
That makes sense.
But for the demo, we won't worry too much about that. So
I'm going to
where are these arrows coming from?
And since it's my hero, I think I'll shoot first and then charge.
There you go. Do it that way.
I'm in range.
Easily in range. Easily in arc.
Okay.
So
my archers.
There you go.
Use a red and a blue.
Red and a blue.
Okay.
So
I just roll these two.
Roll those suckers
and
out.
See what happens.
All right. So you got three damage markers total, so no extra bonuses.
Ouch.
So you're shooting these guys.
That's three spearmen.
Yep, their armor's only one, so you take three of them out. Now, the way this works is you have to start in the back, and then you have to go by tray. But you get to choose right now, because he's got two in the back, which tray to choose from. Yep.
Okay.
So you choose which of those trays he loses three guys from.
I shot at these way back there.
Good shot.
So he takes all from that
tray. All three of them out of that tray, yep.
First blood.
Yeah, good shot, too. Back corner.
Yeah.
So now, because there's still a unit there, that tray stays.
Okay.
Once that unit dies, the tray disappears, which is big for facing and how they touch, and is really big for you with your basic guys, because if there's empty spots in the tray, at the end of the round, you can regen guys. If the tray is gone, cannot. It's gone.
So
that's
a
big deal.
I'd be in good shape because I still have a chance to regen.
Yep, and you'd be able to regen as many guys as there are green runes. Yep.
Okay.
Yep.
So now that I've done this guy, I'm going to charge this guy.
Okay.
So I'm so nervous. I'm super. So is that close enough to get in, or am I like short?
Nope, that's gonna hit. Pretty sure.
Oh, yeah. You're in there.
Yeah, you're good. You're good.
And then I just kind of...
Because it'll be...
Put that right there.
No worries.
Lock them in.
Yeah. Well, you don't need to lock that together.
Oh,
just kind of set it up close.
Okay.
Yep.
Okay.
So the trick is, if you would come in at an angle and bump like this, you just square up when you hit each other.
Okay.
So that's kind of just to keep the facing
easier. Is there any kind of weird, like, technical rule? Like, let's say he's like, is there a range that is considered engaged that we need to check?
Not really. For the way I like to play it, when you have terrain like this and you're using, if it's off by just a hair, You know, I usually say engage it. It's a little easier if you're just playing on a flat mat. And then there is some terrain that'll come in the core set that's just cardboard punch, so it won't affect your movement. But if you want to play with real terrain, it looks a lot better, but it makes the game a little more fiddly.
Like, we're cool with this.
Exactly.
All right. Lord of the Rings players, we're cool with this.
Exactly.
So now you hit. So now, because you got into engagement, using a charge, you get to make your attack.
Okay.
He's poor spearman.
Oh, yeah. So had I just not done it, I would have just in and I would have taken a morale.
And you would have taken a morale for not having charged, just kind of wandering into them, I guess.
Yeah. Oh, sorry.
Oh, what's this here?
Oh, it's a spearman. Okay.
Spearman.
So this is two whites for my hero.
You got the pointy bits.
Oh, my gosh.
So three damage, and you have a surge on there. So now you look and check if your guy has a surge ability that activates during melee.
Now, let me ask you, what's the difference between having this surge ability on the dial and just getting it from the charge attacks?
No difference. All the dial does is just automatically adds one.
So the dial can guarantee a surge, and the dice can produce more.
And that's the trick with his melee attack here. Once he's already engaged, if he does the melee attack, he can choose either extra damage or a surge ability as an automatic. And that's a pretty big, depending on what kind of combos he's trying to set up. So what does that surge ability do on that one?
So it says this attack is treated as having the surge ability, both attack and range of allies at range 1 to 3.
So what that means is he has the surge abilities of any other of his friendly units in range 1 to 3.
Okay. Wow. So 1 to 3.
That's so undead.
The one to look for is check that carry-on Lancer.
Yeah, the Lancer is definitely in there. So he's got add a mortal strike if the defender has a blight token, which he does not.
Unfortunately, at this moment, he does
not. Get one. Okay.
The mortal strike is basically one wound no matter what your defense is.
Nice.
So if he can get blight tokens on you, which are those green kind of poison looking ones, then he can kind of auto damage through, which is a pretty big deal.
Just trying to pass on the conquest.
So three damage. Where do you want to pull it from? So let me riddle you this. Let's say he pulled from here. Did I do 1, 2, 3?
Yep.
Okay.
It has to go from the back even in melee.
Yep.
Okay, so let's clear that one tray and we'll do two off the other one.
One? Yep. That will remove the tray.
Yep.
Is there a good tray technology?
Just kind of slide up more.
There we go.
Ish.
And then
there you go.
Square that guy back up.
Yep.
I like that you square it because that gives you a reference point for whenever you move your trays.
Helps a lot.
2 and 3.
All right. So now that tray is gone. So now how that matters is you still have the two facing. So in melee attacks, you'll still double your damage roll.
Okay.
But now since you don't have a full rank back here, you don't get the full reroll. You only can reroll one of the dice.
Okay.
You're having one tray. If you've got a full rank, let's say you're throwing out three dice, but you have two guys, you can still do a full reroll if you have a full rank, whatever you started at wide.
Beautiful.
All right.
Okay. So that's my five initiative.
So that's that.
I got no fives.
He's got no fives, and you have, that was all your fives, so now sixes.
I have six.
I have six. No sixes. Right.
So you're six.
So I've got just a move 3 with no modifiers.
Okay. So no charge on that.
There's my 3. And I don't know if that won't give me any range, which is cool.
Nice. Nope.
Getting up and close though.
Da, 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 da,
right.
Da, da, da.
So you didn't quite make the hit, which actually is good since you didn't have a charge up.
Right.
So there you sit. So that activation is done.
Yeah, and that's all my guys.
So that's everything you have.
So you can go into me.
So now you go in order of what you got.
I have a 7.
There
and
you
let
go.
Let me tell you, this is about to be a demoralized rank of knights.
Uh-oh.
So
right, because if you don't have a charge, then it's just like you just like ran into each other. You weren't paying attention or something. Yeah. Yeah, exactly.
What's up? Oh, there you go. That. Perfect.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, it comes with some punch terrain. that'll make a difference as far as line of sight goes. There's also one big piece that's kind of a fort that you can actually put units into that change.
And unfortunately,
that's
I had my second one was to go two
other
more.
Things.
So I was going to charge across the field in triumph, but instead I'm just going to get demoralized, I believe.
All right.
Because I accidentally hit somebody.
The orange swirly one.
There it is.
There you go.
Let me ask you, when Christian mentioned it in the in-play report, he said that that it was going to be easy to assemble, not painted. When you said easily to assemble, is this going to be like on a sprue, or is this going to be, okay.
Easy to assemble, yeah, what does that mean?
My understanding is it probably will not be on a sprue.
Okay.
Easy to assemble means
like snap together kind of thing?
They plug together like
ATSD, maybe?
Similar to the ATSD, and then you obviously these ones will probably glue. But yeah, everything's keyed, so it only goes in the way it's supposed to.
Okay.
It closes and everything, so it's actually quite easy to do.
Okay.
Excellent.
That's one thing that's kind of cool, too, is even these ones, the hero type units that are in the base set, they will be selling separate upgrades of them if you want multiples, and they will have different poses as well, which is kind of cool.
So demoralized.
So demoralized.
All right, that's it.
Okay.
That's everything
so
we got.
So that's it for that round. So now what we do is this switches over. We go to round two.
Okay.
Pop it over to you. We chuck these suckers out again. Would you like to do the honors?
I will do the honor.
This is going to be an interesting round.
All right. So now at the end of that round, you didn't have any guys missing, so you didn't need to regen. But now you probably will
it's
after this round.
That was my plan.
And unfortunately, this round, you only got one green rune, so that's a little less good for you.
Yeah. And so to use that, do I need to use the skill? Is that what it is?
That one you actually don't. This one just happens automatically.
Oh,
the
what?
Only time you would need to dial that up is if you specifically wanted to use that skill.
Okay, cool.
Yep. So now you choose. So now the big thing to remember is, since you're already engaged, this is where your attack action comes in, your melee attack. You won't be able to move since you're engaged with each other unless you do a shift. So yeah, that's what you're going to want to dial up mostly.
And I can measure with the range finder.
You can measure with the range ruler as much as you want, just not with maneuver templates.
Okay, cool.
I think we'll try it. We'll try that. Right?
Engaged here?
You are considered engaged there, yes.
Okay.
And he's kind of off to your side a little bit, which in the full game will matter. Flanking, if you hit on the if you're engaged on the side or on the back, will make differences.
Okay.
We're not going to get into all that right now. It just adds extra dice and rerolls and things like that.
Okay.
What does this white symbol do?
So that one is your skill. If there's a thing that has the skill icon like this,
okay,
you could do that with any of the actions.
And okay, this makes sense. So okay, I see. Let's do this. This will be interesting.
Yeah, I sat down with this to demo or to learn it for the first time, and like I saw the minis and started playing, and I'm like, oh, I can dig this. I love Armada, I love X-Wing, I like miniatures games of all kinds. I like this.
And I can't move through my own models, is that right?
You cannot. You would have to basically kind of maneuver around, which is going to be a little difficult right now with that guy.
Let's do, we got some log jam going on.
Yep. On a smaller board, that'll happen. With the core set, with this type of size of army, you'll do like a 3x3, but in the full games, once that comes out, once you have enough to do the full armies, it'll do a 6x3.
Nice.
So you'll have a lot wider area to
make sense.
How are you going to do army building? Is it going to be like there are going to be points, or is it going to
be?
Okay.
This is actually kind of cool and actually a good thing to get into. Good question.
Okay.
So
let's
flip
talk about
this
the points.
Over.
Oh, look at that.
And you buy the units by tray. So one tray would cost you 15 points.
Oh, boy.
Two would cost you 27, so on and so forth. And then this is the different ways you can configure that particular unit's trays. So the carry-on lancers can't do a 2x3 deep, but they can do the 3x2 deep.
Nice.
And every card will show that on the back, their point cost and what type of configurations they can do.
Okay.
The other thing also, in the full game, once you get into upgrade cards, the more units or the more of trays of a certain unit you have together, the better upgrades you could put on those units.
Makes sense.
So
makes
that's pretty cool too.
All right, shall we start with the ones?
Let's do this.
You got any ones?
I don't think there's any one on my
I don't, probably not. Two. Three.
I do have a three.
You have a three?
All right, so.
You've got initiative, yeah.
He's got initiative. So your hero has an attack at 3. So you make your melee attack with the dice you have.
And I get an extra damage right off the bat.
Right off the bat.
So these spearmen are going to have a bad day.
Probably right now. Yeah. Oh, especially if that happens.
All right, so you got the surge.
Yep.
And still the only ability is that he can activate is this one.
Yep.
Which you don't have any blight tokens, so that's going to be
4 total spearmen down.
And 1, 2.
So you go from here.
And then 3, 4?
Yeah. And yep. He gets to choose which tray, so yeah, there you go.
To continue taking from that side.
4.
Yep.
Okay. You can only choose a full or partially empty tray.
Basically, yep.
Okay.
All right, yeah, that's all right. They're spearmen, right?
Yeah,
that's what they're for.
You can regenerate too, right? You got that.
All righty. So, and you had a 3, you said?
I have, I do have some 3s.
Excellent.
Let's start with this 3, which is an immediate attack and then a +1 defense.
All right, so now leave this by your guys this turn, and they have +1 to that shield that you have to hit, and that's pretty big because it adds it multiplies how many wounds it takes to do damage.
Okay, so now it's going to take 3 hits.
3 hits for a wound
to get 1 wound.
It's 4 hits to get 1 or 3 hits to get 1?
3 hits to get 1.
Okay, gotcha.
Yep.
All right, and I got 2 reds and a blue.
There you go.
Is it the same amount of dice regardless of how many you have set up?
Yes.
Okay.
But the big thing now is, so here's how this is going to work.
Okay.
Now that we have something other than one tray, now we get into the multiplying and what they call your threat.
Okay.
So, you rolled out 2 damage.
Yes.
Which would normally just be 2 damage. But because you have 2 trays wide, that's actually 4 damage now.
Okay.
The more trays wide you have, the more you multiply. And that's why wide facings can be very brutal. But because he doesn't have any back, he doesn't get any rerolls, which would have been kind of nice there.
Nice, yeah.
And so that's where the deep comes in, and that's where your squad building at the beginning really makes a difference, because do I go for massive spiky damage?
Yeah.
And more consistent.
It's really interesting, because you make it that line, so you kind of just like are piercing it, so you're better, more likely to hit, but you're not hitting him with as much.
Exactly.
And does it matter the orientation of these troops? Like, I've got one that's not even touching his, doesn't matter?
Doesn't much matter. Nope. Okay. The only way that would matter is if he eliminated one tray to the point that you weren't touching anymore.
Excellent. So. All right, so 4 damage?
So 4 damage went through.
Well, it's a good thing that I'm really tough. Oh, wait. Okay. Yeah. So I'm basically just taking 1 tray away.
One tray away.
Let's take that tray away.
Careful.
How does it feel, Chris?
Oh, I'm so super nervous.
Join me in the land of Hades over here.
I was already there.
And the nice thing about that attack is you cleared a whole tray, so you can't actually regen guys there.
That's
it's
great.
Very big.
Oh, it's important.
Gosh. Oh my gosh.
It's really a pull up. Yeah, that's the best best way to do it.
Slide up. So the way that would work in the full game, it's actually, when you're doing, have you played Armada much? Okay. So the way you do
it is
there
three.
Will
do you have
be
any
these
threes?
Deployment cards that actually show you where you deploy on the field.
Right.
You'll bring a couple of those, and the other person brings a couple of those.
Bank
and you
charge,
also have
objective
cards,
one
and
bank
you lay
charge.
Those out, and one person gets
which
to choose
first, is
either the
enough.
Deployments
we'll see how this
from
works.
The different
I think
deployments
this like,
or from the different objectives, and the other person chooses
right?
the other. So let's say I'm like, I want the objective where I have to hunt down your hero. The other guy could choose deployment zones that maybe go against that.
If my movement is overlapping like so, do I engage him?
You just go as far as you can along it, and engage right up and just square up.
Well, I had a charge. So
you had a charge.
That seems good, right?
All
right.
So.
See what Carrie can do.
She's got a little less good dice. Instead of the 2 whites, she has a white and a blue.
Okay.
But she also has a special ability on her melee attacks with a surge. So if you pull up a surge, check that out.
Surge on.
All right.
All right.
So. 2 damage.
And the surge says, choose another enemy unit at range 1 to 5. That enemy suffers 2 damage per surge spent.
So for every surge she rolled, she can do 2 damage to someone within range, I think it was 5, right?
Range 5, yeah.
That is pretty much anybody in my army.
Let's cling these Carrion Lancers with 2 damage. How about that? And is that straight through the armor?
Straight? Yeah, it's basically hits the armor just like it normally would.
Oh, it hits the armor.
Yeah.
I want to go for these guys.
Let's go for the archers. Are they 1-1s?
They're 1-1s.
Yeah.
Yep.
These guys are just going to reanimate
so
on me.
So that's two off of there.
And then two damage to your main guy, which maybe not do anything.
No,
I don't know what's his armor.
3-4.
3-4.
So
yep.
Just
except
off.
That she has Brutal 1.
Okay.
And what Brutal does is it acts as another facing. Because she has Brutal 1, it's one extra facing. So that two damage is actually 4.
So that's enough to do one damage.
So that's enough to do one wound to him. So if you don't mind grabbing a little wound X token there, so there you go. Yep, just like that.
Do you guys recommend putting it on the cards or right next to it?
Whatever works best for you. It's kind of like, I don't know. Like games I play, I like to do it as much on the board as possible. But if it gets a little crowded.
Sure.
All right, that's my three.
All right.
Okay. Threes.
And so that's where his hero has a little bit better dice for damage and more abilities, whereas hers are just straight up do a bunch of damage and then that range damage as well. She's firing her bow into the air while she's attacking.
Absolutely.
All right. So let's finish up this round and see where it goes.
Absolutely.
So that was number, what were we on?
It was three.
That was three. Yeah, and we got a lot down in three. Yeah.
Four?
We got two.
Oh.
No force.
So you do both your fours?
All right. So maybe I'm going to go with this. And I got this guy. So let's go with these to attack into them.
All right.
So they got the demoral, so they just get a token?
They just get, they just get that with your dice result. Okay. And that's when you can activate now with the token they already have.
Perfect.
And that's actually good because now we can get that morale deck.
All right, so I'm
and that's
going
to be about the last thing we need to really go over, so it'll be nice.
How about thee?
Wow.
Okay.
Look at that.
But
I get a reroll, right?
You do. You don't have a full rank, so you don't get a full reroll, but you do have one trace. You can reroll one die.
Good luck.
There you go. So, because you have two facings, you have two damage there.
Yes.
You double it. Uh-huh. So that should be enough to get through,
except
he was plus one. So,
tactics.
Nothing died. No. However, you do also have, I don't think these guys have a good surge symbol, do they? So that doesn't matter. So what's going to matter now is this symbol here. Because you have that and that, you have two. So you draw two cards off the top.
Okay.
It's like that X-Wing critical deck right there.
Yep. And now you can buy or use one of these cards that has two or less symbols, which is either one. So you can choose one of those to do.
If he takes the two, does he spin this token off of me, basically?
He spins this token automatically by just doing the morale action, which you wouldn't necessarily have to do.
Yeah.
But
in this case, it's a good time. Loss of faith looks brutal.
All right, so let's see what that one says.
You don't
says.
Want knights without faith. I mean, that's tough.
So loss of faith. If the unit has more than one tray, your opponent must choose and remove one tray from the unit's backmost rank.
Oh, man.
What?
So that was pretty bad.
Like six damage right there. That's insane. Yep.
That's one of those ones that against, like, say, your footmen and stuff might not be that bad, but against knights, it's pretty brutal.
Yeah.
And that's where morale can really come into play and really be nasty if you let it build up.
That was like the scoop shadow card. You're like, okay, let's just start over.
Yeah, man.
So
that's awesome.
I played this modifier, so it gave me
those
one
go.
Morale.
Discard.
And because he had moved into me without charging, he got another one, so I had the two.
I like how that morale stacks up.
Yeah,
right?
That was really cool.
Really cool.
Pretty vicious.
So had he not... like just bumped into me and I just had the one, I would just draw the one card.
Just drawn the one card and only been able to play it if it was one.
Gotcha.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Exactly.
All right, and then your archers, I believe, are going? I've got...
No, it's this guy.
Okay, yeah, that's right.
So he's got a two church.
All right.
That looks good.
He looks like he's in?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, he's in.
He's in.
Look at that beautiful maneuvering.
Oh, my gosh.
Look, it's like a case. Like
a glove.
Locks in.
All right. So now because you have the charge, you get to do an attack.
Okay.
That just goes with him.
So he's got one, two, and...
These poor spearmen.
Yeah. What would they ever do? I just want to get to your rune golem. So
yeah. He's waiting, actually. Yeah. He's waiting for you to get through there.
This is just working, you know? All right. And, yeah, I just had the charge in there, so... Okay, so this I got one hit, and that is the accuracy.
Yep. The accuracy won't matter right now.
Okay.
That's just to pick off upgraded guys that are in a normal unit.
Okay.
forward, because you always have to take from
it's
the
like
back row first. Yep,
okay.
And so it's like, that guy is a special guy. Get him. So that's what that'll do.
So did I get in here with just one damage?
You got
that true?
One damage, because unfortunately no rerolls since you're just one tray.
So now I will still get times two on my...
Yes. Yep.
That's,
oh,
and that's really
big.
Nice.
That's
there's,
big.
There's good and bad right there. But,
yep.
That's okay. I'll take it.
All righty.
What do you want? Fives?
I got a five.
Go ahead.
Shoot, and I think I'm going to shoot into the knights, even though it's going to put a morale onto
there's
my,
zombies.
My VIPs right there. My
there's zombies.
Okay, so I guess I need
oh, good call.
Morale token for them.
All right.
Yep.
And then is there anything else to them, or is it just the morale?
Just that. Yep.
Okay.
So, yeah, morale... At first, doesn't seem like it's that big of a cost, but depending
like that,
on the cards,
yeah.
It can be very bad.
Brutal. Yeah.
Yep.
So shooting the knights, eh? Feeling lucky?
Yep.
And I got them around.
Oh, nice. Nice.
So that was against the knights, you said?
Yes.
And not only that, but the three damage that was needed to actually break through the two armor
is actually
plus one for the thing.
Is actually six also
damage.
Because he's got the double facing. Or
no,
that was
no, it was this. It was just this one.
Oh, just those
so
two.
It's four damage.
Okay,
so
it's
four damage. And so I have three defense because I took my little special plus unit.
Yep.
So it's one.
So it's one wound, but they only have one wound, so it's one unit.
So I take my morale.
Grab.
Right.
Yep, you can
but
do
I only
that.
Had one, so this is
so
just wasted.
That's
so.
Wasted this time. Yep.
It was a good shot.
Yeah. Each of your units at range 1 to 2 of the unit received one inspiration token. So that would have been cool.
Would have gotten you some inspiration.
Whatever that means.
Inspiration, so here's the thing. When you have these tokens or like blight tokens and stuff, the rally symbol on here, sometimes it's an action, sometimes it's a modifier, depending on the unit.
Yeah.
The rally symbol, if you activate with that, will remove all bad tokens from that unit.
Oh, okay.
And then, if you get an inspiration token, like say you activate this and have no tokens on you, you get an inspiration token, or if they get them through another way, you hold on to that inspiration token on that unit, and you can spend it later to get rid of one bad token.
Okay.
So that's a way to get rid of the morale. You basically rally the troops, get them together, and go from there.
All right, so I've got 2 7s. You don't have anything left?
No, I'm done. I'm spent.
All right, let's start with this guy. We will show off that mechanic right there. So we got a one sidestep.
Yep.
Okay.
And
so with the shift, you can go side or back forward,
you
however
to
you want
to
do.
Full amount, or can you like?
You have. Yep, you have to move the full amount.
Okay.
And then the same rules apply. It's a normal move as far as bumping goes. So if you run into something, it's not good for you since it's not a charge.
Okay.
But that's the only way to disengage once you're engaged as well. You'll take a morale for it, but sometimes it's worth it to get your guys out of there and let something else get in front.
Okay.
All right, so we moved him here.
All right.
And then...
So now you also have that rally modifier on him.
And then I chose the white, the rally, so I get to remove this negative
token. That token. There you
He's
go.
He's waiting for you back
yeah.
here.
So come on, come
and then me. Finally, we've got our spearman going to do some serious action here.
There you
so
go.
So you get to engage with two guys. Does he have to pick before he attacks who he's going to go on?
Yes. Yep. So you pick who you're attacking first.
We want to attack...
This guy's 3-3, and this one is... Well, they're both 3-3 now, because he's got one.
Let's see this guy.
Okay.
All right, so we got to attack. The spearmen are rolling a... Green or a red and a blue.
There you go.
I've got plus one from the.
And they got two serious marker things. Oh.
So.
All right.
He as of right now has two damage results.
Yeah.
And then he also has.
No.
The
Receive
double
one
things.
Inspiration.
So you'd get an inspiration token for
is
them.
Is that what this is?
Yep.
So it's. He's also got that. So is it actually?
1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah,
and
because I have the extra damage.
Yep.
Yeah.
So that's enough to get another damage onto him.
Yep.
Okay.
So now that would put a second wound on the hero.
Beautiful. Well, I think we've seen it. Chris,
say,
you feel
yeah.
good about it?
I feel good. I mean,
great game.
Yeah, that was really cool.
Thank you so much for the demo, man.
For sure. For
Excellently
sure. Thanks
done.
For playing.
Yeah,
so,
thank you so much.
This is Ruin Wars, the new miniatures game from Fantasy Flight Games. Trays, look at the models. I mean, really cool. Check this game out. We're here at CinCon 2016. We got more coming. Stay tuned.